dear students, welcome again after Diwali vacation. I hope you have enjoyed your vacation very well and with the enthusiasm and with the lots of farah. Okay. Now we are going to start our new chapter in maths, that is fractions. Okay. You know fractions means what? See, before that I would like to show you something. See, this is your textbook. I hope everyone is having your maths textbook with you. Open that. See the first page. Okay, here our new chapter fraction is starting. See, here it is, name of the chapter fraction. So in the background of this name, there are some pictures of fruits. Can you observe? Yeah, right. If you'll observe here, there are watermelon, pieces of watermelon, bananas, there is strawberry, and it is, I think, orange. Okay. So, why these fruits are given there? Why? See, they have not given whole fruit, picture of whole fruit. They have given picture of pieces of fruits. What is purpose behind it? What is purpose behind the giving pieces of fruits? The fruits in the pieces. Why they have given? I'm going to tell you. Have you thought ever why they have given pieces? Have you thought ever? Okay, you can think now. Be there for 1 minute. Pause this video. Think for 1 minute. Okay, so see here, why they have given the these pictures of these fruits in the form of pieces? Because fraction means what? Fractions means pieces. Fraction means pieces. We called in maths, we called it parts. Okay, so fraction, this concept is related with the part, but part of whole. Whole means part of whole. WHOLE, whole. Whole means complete, one. Okay, whole, complete one. So if you see here, they have given pieces of watermelon. Okay, so this piece of watermelon is part of this whole watermelon. Here there are bananas, here there are strawberries. Okay, four strawberries are there. Here is one apple. Okay. Blackberries are there. Okay. Oranges are there. Oranges are also given in the form of parts. Okay. So, you know that a fraction means parts of whole. For example, what is mean by part of whole? Suppose this is watermelon. This is one whole watermelon. Whole means complete one. This is complete one watermelon. And now this watermelon is divided into four equal parts. Four equal parts. And out of four equal parts, this one part which I have shaded here, this one part I ate. I like watermelon. So I ate one part of the out of this four equal part, one part I ate. Okay, that means if somebody asks me how much watermelon have you eaten, how much watermelon, remember here, how much watermelon have you eaten or have I eaten, then what I'll say? They have not asked how many part out of four, how many part I have eaten, one part, but how much watermelon I have eaten. If you want to get the answer of this question, how much watermelon I have eaten, we need to understand the concept of fraction. The answer of this question is told by this concept, fraction. Okay, now see, I'll tell you answer. Out of four equal parts, I have ate one part. That means out of four equal part, I have ate one part. That I have eaten one part. That means I have eaten 1/4 watermelon. I have eaten 1/4 watermelon. ओके, 1/4 वॉटरमेलन. आई हैव इटन 1/4 वॉटरमेलन. ओके, सो 1/4 इज द फॉर्म ऑफ फ्रैक्शन. 1/4 इज कॉल्ड फ्रैक्शन. अंडरस्टूड? 1 out of 4. नाउ दिस इफ यू सी हियर, 4 मीन्स वॉट? 4 मीन्स वॉट? टोटल इक्वल पार्ट्स. टोटल इक्वल पार्ट्स. And out, and this one indicates the part which I have eaten. That means the part which I have shaded. We can say it shaded parts. Okay, shaded or unshaded, whatever. Here shaded part. Okay, that see this. What is called? I will tell you afterwards. The name of these shaded parts and the number indicating shaded part, the number indicating total equal part. That I will tell you afterwards. But this is called fraction, okay? 1 out of 4, 1/4. 1/4 watermelon I have eaten, so 1/4 is called fraction, part of whole. See this, I ate one part of this whole watermelon, okay? So fraction means what? Part of whole. If you'll see again here, if you will see again here, some pictures are given. One girl is saying to her mom, "Mom, give me half a cup of tea." Half cup of tea. So half means what? Half cup of tea means what? Yes, the cup should be divided into two equal parts and one part should be filled. Okay, that is called half part. Okay. Whereas teacher is telling in the telling to the student, today 1/3 of class is absent. 1/3 of the class is absent. What is meaning of this 1/3? 1/3 means this. 1/3 of the class is absent. Means 1/3 student of the class are absent. Means what? Suppose there are 15 student in the class. 15 students. Okay. 1/3 this 3 indicates total equal parts, means 15 students are divided into 3 equal parts. So 3 means 5 5 5, 5 threes are 15, no? So 5 student will be in one part, 5 student will be in another part, 5 student will be in third part. Okay, so out of these 3 parts, one is absent, one part is absent. That means 5 students are absent. 1/3 of 15 means 5 students are absent. So when teacher says today 1/3 of the class is absent, that means if there are 15 students in the class, 5 students are absent. 1/3 means 5. Okay, so this is meaning of 1/3. In the next picture, see these pictures. I will eat 1/4 of the pastries. 1/4 of the pastries. Again, see 1/4 means what? There are 4 pieces of pastries. 1 2 3 4. 4 pieces of pastries are there, and out of 4 I will eat one piece. Okay, that means 1/4 of the pastries I will eat. This is the meaning of fraction. This you have learned already in the first, second and third standard. This is just revision for you. Okay, now see here, I'll show you some pictures. See this picture of watermelon. The watermelon is divided into or cut into 8 equal pieces. One more thing in the fraction, the pieces or parts which will be parts of whole will be there. Those all parts must be equal. Okay. So see the in this picture, there are 8 parts of the watermelon. And out of 8 parts, suppose I want to eat one of the part, then I will say I have eaten 1/8 of the watermelon. Understood? Suppose I have to eat 3 parts out of 8. There are 8 parts of the watermelon. I want to eat 3 parts. Then how much watermelon I will eat? 3/8 of the watermelon. 3/8 watermelon I will eat. Okay. Okay, see this another picture. Here some strips are given. Okay, that each strip, So see the first strip. First strip indicates one hole, complete one. One hole. W-H-O-L-E, hole. It is not divided into any part. It is complete one strip. Okay, so it's called hole or one. See the second strip. It is divided into how many equal parts? It is divided into two equal parts. So two equal parts. It is divided into two equal parts. So each part is called as 1/2, 1/2. See, it is written there, okay? So 1/2 means half, half. Out of two equal part, one part means half and another part means half. So two half makes one whole. See the third strip, it is divided into three equal parts. So each part is called 1/3, 1/3 and 1/3. 3 1/3 make one whole. See fourth strip, it is divided into four equal parts and each part is called as 1/4, 1/4, 1/4, 1/4, 1/4, 1/4 and 1/4. So 4 1/4 makes one whole, one whole. Okay. See fifth one, it is divided into 5 equal parts and each part is called as 1/5. Each of those part is called as 1/5, 1/5, 1/5. So 5 times 1/5 makes one whole. Okay, so this is the concept of the fraction. Now see here, turn your page of the textbook. Let us remember. Do you remember? See here, shade one by two part of each of the following. Some figures are given here, like this. Circle is given and it is divided into two equal parts. Another oval is given, it is also divided into two equal parts. Then diamond is given, it is also divided into two equal parts. Okay, shade 1/2, shade one part out of two. So see here, two means total equal parts. So if you'll observe each of this figure, all figures are divided into two equal parts, okay? And out of two, we have to shade one. We have to shade one. So if you have pencil, use pencil here to shade. You can shade in this way. Okay? Any out of two, any one part you can shade. Here also. Okay, so the shaded part represent 1/2, one out of two, and it's also called as half. Okay, second, shade 1/3 part of each of the following. So 1/3 means this way, 1/3. There will be three equal parts of that figure, you have to shade one. Okay, so similarly you have to shade today within this period, you have to shade all these. Where in another they have given 2/3 means out of three you have to shade two parts. Then there is 1/4, out of four equal parts you have to shade one. Then there is 3/4, four equal parts are there, out of four equal parts you have to shade three. Okay, so complete this today. Tomorrow we will learn the concept of fraction in detail. Okay, so thank you for today and have a nice day.